Hello students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Today we are going to discuss the continuation of unit 16. In the previous session we have completed pituitary gland and its hormones. Today we are going to discuss thyroid gland. This thyroid gland is located in our neck region. Okay, so it is located in our neck region and it is composed of two distinct lobes. Okay, so thyroid gland is composed of two distinct lobes. Now you look at this picture. This is the first lobe and this is the second lobe. Okay, so this is the front view of thyroid gland. Yes, so it is composed of two distinct lobes lying one on either side of the trachea. Okay, so it is lying one on either side of the trachea. Okay, so how many lobes are present? Two lobes. Okay, it is composed of two lobes. And these two lobes are connected by narrow band of tissues. So this is the narrow band of tissue. So this narrow band of tissues are known as what? Isthmus. So narrow band of tissue is known as isthmus. Understand? So this is the right lobe and this is the left lobe, and these two lobes are connected by narrow band of tissue, that is known as isthmus. Okay, now look at this picture. This is the back view of thyroid gland. So here four oval shaped structures are present. That structures are known as parathyroid gland. Okay, so four oval shaped structures are present. They are known as parathyroid gland. So that one we can learn later. This gland is composed of glandular follicles. So this is the follicle cells. So the gland is composed of glandular follicles and it is lined by cuboidal epithelium. So this is the epithelial cells, cuboidal epithelium. The follicles contain colloid material. That colloid material is known as thyroglobulin. So this region is the colloid material. So the colloid material is full of thyroglobulin. Understand? So the gland is composed of glandular follicles and it is lined by cuboidal epithelium. The follicles contain colloid material. That colloid material is known as thyroglobulin. Then an amino acid tyrosine and iodine is involved in the formation of thyroid hormone. So what are the two things involved in the formation of thyroid hormone? An amino acid tyrosine and iodine is involved in the formation of thyroid hormone. Now let's see the hormones secreted by the thyroid gland. So two hormones are secreted by the thyroid gland. They are triiodothyronine and tetraiodothyronine or thyroxine. Here I have given three colors so that you can pronounce easily. Okay, triiodothyronine or T3, then tetraiodothyronine or thyroxine or T4. So what are the two hormones are secreted by the thyroid gland? Triiodothyronine T3 and tetraiodothyronine or thyroxine, that is T4. Tri means 3. Okay, so T3. Tetra 4, T4. Right, children? Okay, so then some more information also you have to remember. That is, this thyroxine hormone was first crystallized by Edward C. Kentel in 1914. So first crystallized by one scientist, the name of the scientist is Edward C. Kendall in 1914, and Charles Harrington and George Berger, these two scientists identified the molecular structure of thyroxine in 1927. Charles Harrington and George Berger in 1927, is it? So they have identified the molecular structure or chemical structure of thyroxine. Okay, then the thyroid gland requires 120 mg of iodine for the production of thyroxine per day, every day. Okay, so thyroid gland requires 120 mg of iodine per day for the production of thyroxine. This is an important one word how to remember. So per day thyroid gland requires 120 mg of iodine, Now let's see the functions of thyroid gland, functions of thyroid hormones. So, first function is production of energy by maintaining the basal metabolic rate of the body. Production of energy by maintaining the basal metabolic rate of the body, BMR. What is meant by BMR? The rate at which the body uses energy while at rest to maintain vital functions such as breathing and keeping warm. So what is BMR? The rate at which the body uses energy while at rest to maintain vital functions such as breathing and keeping warm. Second one, helps to maintain normal body temperature. Normal body temperature. So this hormone maintains the normal body temperature of the particular person. Then influences the activity of central nervous system. It influences the activity of central nervous system. Controls growth of the body and bone formation. Growth of the body and bone formation. Then essential for normal physical, mental and personality development. So this hormone is essential for the normal physical, mental and personality development. So it is known as personality hormone. Because of that it is known as personality hormone. Why the hormone is known as personality hormone? It is essential for normal physical, mental and personality development. So it is known as personality hormone. So one question also given at the back, that is book back evaluation, Roman number 7, 9th question. Why are thyroid hormones referred as personality hormone? Now note it down. So the answer is, it is essential for normal physical, mental and personality development. So it is known as personality hormone. Then last one is regulates cell metabolism. So these are the functions of thyroid hormones. Write down the question. Write the functions of thyroid hormones. So these all the functions have to learn. Thyroid dysfunction. What's the meaning of dysfunction? Thyroid gland is not functioning properly. So that is known as dysfunction. Okay, thyroid gland is not functioning properly. That means sometimes it may secrete excess amount of hormones or it may secrete less amount of hormones. That condition is known as thyroid dysfunction. Okay, it secretes excess amount of hormones or less amount of hormones. That is known as thyroid dysfunction. So here also two types of dysfunctions are there. One is hypothyroidism and another one is hyperthyroidism. Hypo meaning less amount. Okay, less secretion of hormones. Hyper meaning excess secretion. Okay, first let's see hypothyroidism. So it is due to the decreased secretion of thyroid hormone. When the thyroid hormone is secreted, if the thyroid hormone is secreted by the thyroid gland, is it? So the amount is very, very less or decreased secretion. That condition is known as what? Hypothyroidism. So here also some problems also there. That is first condition is known as goiter. See in this diagram, this lady is suffering from goiter disease. So here in the neck region fully swollen. Is it? So it is caused due to the inadequate supply of iodine in our diet. So when we are eating food, we have to eat proper amount of iodine content. Is it? Iodine rich food only have to eat. So when it is, when the iodine content is less, this condition may arise so that we have to eat the iodine rich food, that is fishes, seaweed, dairy products, grains and cereals. That food items we have to eat. So maximum this problem or this disease cannot arise. It leads to the enlargement of thyroid gland, which protrudes as marked swelling in the neck, and it is called as goiter. So here thyroid gland swollen. Because of that swollen, here the neck protrudes outside. Is it? The gland protrudes outside. So this condition is known as what? Goiter. So this is the first disease, that is goiter. Second one is cretinism. This is a cretinism. Yes, this disease is known as cretinism. So it is caused due to the decreased secretion of thyroid hormone. So it is also caused due to the less secretion of thyroid hormone. Is it? It affects only in children. This cretinism affects children. The condition of stunted growth, the growth, the proper growth is not there, and mental defect. Mentally, they are retarded. The lack of skeletal development and deformed bones, the bones and all not developed properly. So this condition is known as cretinism. So these children are, these babies are known as cretins. Is this, they are called as cretins. This condition is known as cretinism. The third disease is known as myxedema. Myxoedema, that is a third disease. It is also caused the deficiency of thyroid hormones in adults. So maximum adult person only may get the myxoedema. They are mentally sluggish. Mental development is not proper. Then increase in body weight, puffiness of the face and hand, and odematous appearance, that is a swollen appearance. So it affects only the adult person. So these three diseases are because of the decreased secretion of thyroid hormone. The next one is hyperthyroidism. Hyperthyroidism meaning it is caused due to the excess secretion of thyroid hormones. Is it? So this condition, this disease is known as Graves' disease. This is a Graves' disease. So this Graves' disease, another name is exophthalmia. The symptoms are protrusion of the eyeballs. The eyeballs are protruded. The eyeballs protrudes outside. So this is exophthalmia. Then increased metabolic rate. Metabolic rate also increased. Body temperature is very high. Then profuse sweating, often sweating. Then loss of body weight and nervousness. These are the symptoms of Graves' disease. Have you all understood? Now see in this picture, cretinism, so pale color, then puffy face, then pot bellied stomach and protruding umbilicus. Is it? So these are the symptoms of cretinism. This baby also affected by cretinism. Then this one, that is a goiter. Then this is Graves' disease. Now let me give one small recap. So today we have discussed about structure of thyroid gland, location of thyroid gland, where it is located, then functions of thyroid gland. Functions, we have studied 7 functions. Then thyroid dysfunction, that is hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. Under the hypothyroidism, 3 more diseases: goiter, cretinism and myxoedema. So these are the topics today we have completed. I hope you all understood. Anyway, today's study portion is the functions of thyroid gland. It is given in page number 235. So 7 points are given. You have to learn any 4 functions. Functions of thyroid gland. This is your today's study portion. Thank you.